MK Party has released a statement concerning the SABC use of the term GNU, which they say it is misleading. Now, don't worry, guys. As look, MK Party says that the High Court will address the agent application submitted by Umkhonto weSizwe Party President Jacob Zuma, which seeks to compel the South African Broadcasting Corporate SABC to cease referring to the DA and ANC coalition as a government of national unity. All right, now, but I need to give you context to this. Now, the context that I can give you is this one. The first one is the fact that, this is very interesting. The context that you need to understand is the fact that, Helen Zille, where is that video? I need that video, Helen Zille, where she says, Oibo, this is not a government of national unity. This is a grand coalition between the ANC and the DA. She said it. So MK Party was never wrong because look, a member of the DA in Kurundekula standing, as we know, Fikile Mbalula, a member of ANC in Kurundekula standing. Well, ANC and DA is actually the same thing. At least we have come to realize that now. That is actually the same thing, so that's why we will easily mistaken them. You know what I'm saying? Because their identity is the same. Whatever the Ramaphosa believes that is wrong, even the DA believes that is wrong. You know what I'm saying? No, wait. So, Helen Zille, in her own mouth, she believes that, that's according to Helen Zille. She believes that, this is not a coalition. This is not a government of national unity. Remember, Helen Zille played a very pivotal role in making sure that today we have the government of national unity. At least government of national unity. Government of national unity. We now know. So the MK Party released a statement, agent media statement, dated 12th August 2024. It is this statement that makes me want to say we need to have a conversation. And the conversation is interesting. And we're definitely going to have one. We're not going to deprive ourselves. Lapo, forget it, it's mine. But before we can do so, I want you guys to listen attentively to what I'm about to tell you. Then, remember what I've just already told you about this woman. What I've already told you about this woman. Ugogo Helen Zille. Pack that. We'll come back to this one. But this is what you need to do.
If you're not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, so I think it's worth of our time now. Let's go for it. Statement on the SABC continued use of the misleading GNU term, says MK Party. Tomorrow, the 13th of August 2024, the Johannesburg High Court will hear the address, the agent application submitted by Umkhonto weSizwe Party President Jacob Zuma, which seeks to compel the South African Broadcasting Corporation, SABC, to cease referring to the DA and the ANC coalition as a government of national unity. I've already told you, when I said PAC, I told you that that was not a government of national unity. In fact, previously I've referred to it as a government of national confusion. But it turns out, it's not even a government of national confusion. It's a coalition between DA and ANC. Well, what's your source, Bongs? None other than Kok Helen Zille. Let's go. Second paragraph. The SAPC should not serve as a conduit for the Democratic Alliance and the ANC of Cyril Ramaphosa. As this misrepresentation undermines the integrity of Section 3, bracket 1A of the Broadcasting Act 4 of 1999 and the principle outlined in the SAPC Charter regarding editorial independence. Yalola MK. MK Party Yalola. Angazi ukuthi wayebalo kodwa bayalola. However way you wanna see it, kodwa la bayalo. Bariyadlule lapho, vela sikho lapho. Mabaqhubeka bathi. Now quoting exactly what I said. Listen to this one. I mean, Angsazi. Maybe you know, I don't know. DA Federal Chair Helen Zille has acknowledged this coalition as a partnership between the DA and the ANC rather than a genuine government of national unity, revealing the deceptive nature of this arrangement. Now, if you don't know, Helen Zille had a conversation not long ago, that's where she revealed that no, actually this is not a coalition, this is a government of, this is not a government of national unity, but rather a coalition between the ANC and the DA. So, let me repeat this one. DA Federal Chair Helen Zille has acknowledged this coalition as a partnership between the DA and the ANC, rather than a genuine government of national unity, revealing the deceptive nature of the arrangement. You see, again, they're approving MK Party, right? Because MK Party has been saying this is not a government of national unity, but rather this is a deception. Well, that's what they said. Ask me, I'll tell you. That's what they said. But the paragraph continues to say, the SAPC must uphold its duty to accurately represent political alliance without serving as a mouthpiece for partisan agendas. Despite the Umkhonto we Sizwe request for opposing affidavit, the SAPC has not responded, reinforcing the need for the court to grant the relief sought by Umkhonto we Sizwe. We remain committed to defending the editorial independence of SAPC and ensuring that the SAPC public is not misled by state-affiliated entities. Oh, my God. Yo, bayalo laba. Bayalo laba. MK Party. Well, speaking about MK Party, did I tell you? I must have forgotten about this one. I must have forgotten. I really have forgotten that. Hey, Nina, guys. Nayindabala. Kuthiwa. Pagati, manduta yakithi. Le, ku MK Party. There are ANC spies in the MK Party. Oh, it's not me. I got it from somewhere. Man. Let me open this for you. Because I know you'll be like, oh, Bongs, where are you getting this news? It was released by it's called Sunday Tribute August. I think it's Sunday World. I'm not sure. On the 11th of August 2024, they say ANC spies in the MK party. Well, that alone says to me, that's the reason why Zuma had to remove certain people and place people. And it's because the ANC is, the MK party is infiltrated by the enemy. Ah, yes, I got it. Tell me what you think about it. I'm very keen to hear your thought and your opinion about it in the comment section below. Yeah, aye.